In this video, we will create a neural section like Netflix in just 3 simple steps. Let's make it right away using the new Figma variables. So, I'm in the file of my previous video. You can access the link in the description and you have there the carousel already linked, and we will use it as a base to create our hero section. So now the first step is to create our hero backgrounds. So here on the right hand side, I will quickly draw a frame that can has 40 by 70. Okay, and this will be our hero for the automotive background. So I will grab my plugin and splash again and load here the car from my automotive, and I can change already the frame name to automotive, but I want this to be darker. So here my image will be 50% opacity, and the background instead of white will be dark. And I also want an overlay that can be also 50%, but I want this to be a gradient here, and the darkest part will be down below, and in the middle can be transparent, just like that. Okay, so now the style is applied, we need to create this component. So let's make it a component, and also we will make the variables of it. So here again, add the variant, and this variant will be the train, the bridge train, which will be our second movie card, and we can already change the image. Then we can add another variant here down below that will be our underground movie, and we can rename here the property to underground. This will be important because when we will set the variables, we need to have the same names across all our frames that will match, so that when I click underground, I will also see the background of the underground movie. Then the next up is in the code. So let me just quickly change here the property in the code, and at last wire it. Okay, now we have our backgrounds. So let me just recall this component set as hero backgrounds, and here instead of being default, it's automotive. Okay, so now let's create our movie title and descriptions. So here let's type some text. So I will create some text layers just like that. 36, this will be our style from Netflix or something like that. Then here can be the title, so automotive, our movie title. Make it also one bold, and then I have already here some text that I can fill in. I don't want this in bold, make it regular and decrease a little bit the size. Okay, something like this. Okay, so now let's add some buttons. We will add the watch now primary button that I can hit shift A to apply auto layout to hit, and change the color to black and the fill to white. Increase here a little bit the size, and I will quickly draw a play button using the pen tool just like that, and set the fill to black and just arrange it here inside. Nice. Then I will duplicate it to make my secondary button to add to my list. So here my list, and I can delete this icon, and it pretty much it. So I will now select all of this and turn it into a component. And now let's create the variants of this. So I will click here, and we have now our second variant. Let's just rename our component set to movie title and descriptions, and this one will be the automotive. This is very important to do in our workflow for this example, so don't forget it. This one will be the bridge train. So let me update here the text. I will fast forward this because the steps are repeated. And there you go. We have all our movie title and descriptions variants created. So don't forget, everyone needs to have the property with the name of the movie. Okay. So just check if everything is the same. It looks so. So now the next step is to create the string variables. So with nothing selected, we have here on the right hand side the local variables. And here I want to create a variable that is a string, and we can call it movie, and for example automotive. And that's it. For this case, we just need to create one because we will only have one hero, and in that frame they will call everything that is related to the first prototyping that we make here in the left hand side on the last video. And since everything is linked and with the name, the same names, they will apply everywhere. So you will see in a moment what I'm trying to say. So quickly draw a new frame that will be our hero. So 1440, 870, and we can call it hero section. And now what we need to do is to grab our assets that we created. So we have here our hero backgrounds, and we want also the movie title. And as you can see, we don't have all of them here because it's their variants, and they will call their variants every time. And then the carousel. I think I will need to adjust here the sizes, especially with the buttons. So I will quickly do that. Okay, so now we gain some space here in our hero section. And let me just adjust this a little bit more. Okay, just like that. And now we need to link this to the local variables that we created. So if we go here, we select our title, movie title and description. And if you go here onto the right hand side, you have this icon close to property that will appear. And here you will set the movie variable. So now it's linked to movie. Then here the same thing. You go here, it's the selected movie automotive, it's the current variant, and you will link this to the variant that you created. So again, movie. Okay, now we just need to set the variable for our heroes, for our background. But as you can see here, it's different because I'm selecting the frame. So as you can see here in the layers, I'm selecting the main frame because I just click it once. To select the background, the hero background, you need to click two times. And now you see that I'm selecting here my hero background. And here the attributes already changed, and I can now click here to assign variable, and I can select the movie variable. Okay, now before we go into the prototype, we can switch here to the tab prototype, and we should set this frame as our starting point for this prototype, because if you are using the same file from the last video, the prototype will start in the other image, and we want to start at these hero sections. So you need to right click here in this frame and add a starting point. And now you are able to start your prototype. And there you go. Here's the final result in just simple steps. If you liked the video, please thumbs up and leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you and have a great day.